How to prevent coronavirus? 15 tips for coronavirus prevention. Hi guys, my name is Elena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel Psychology of Happiness. Today's Q&A video is called 15 Simple Coronavirus Prevention Tips. I will share with you medical and psychological tips. This information is from the CDC and from my personal doctor's network. We will talk about drinking alcohol during the epidemic, about eating onions, and why you should avoid urgent care and small private clinics. So let's start. The first tip for coronavirus prevention is do not drink alcohol. Your throat has receptors that prevent the virus from coming in. Alcohol lowers the sensitivity of those receptors. Therefore, if you drink alcohol, especially in a public place, you are increasing your chance of catching the virus. Also, alcohol weakens your immune system, which is the only defense that you have against coronavirus. The second coronavirus prevention tip is eat fresh raw onion. Green onion, white onion, red onion. If you catch coronavirus, it will stay in your throat for some time. By eating onion, you have a chance of killing it on the spot. You can add a fresh onion to your salad or to your burger patty. It should be a raw, juicy onion, not a grilled onion. There are no official studies that onion juice kills coronavirus. This is more like a grandmother remedy. Some doctors believe that it helps. I personally like onion, so why not? It's not gonna kill me, but if there is a chance to lower my risk of getting sick, then I'm in. The third tip is to gargle 1 to 2 times a day with warm, salty water. Same effect as onion, but no bad smell from your mouth. If you gargle with salt water, you have a chance of killing the virus before it goes into your lungs. Tip number 4, wash your hands for 20 seconds. 20 seconds is approximately how long it takes to kill the virus on your hands. Washing for 20 seconds means using soap for 20 seconds. When I told my stepdaughter, she decided to play with water for 20 seconds. So, play for 20 seconds with soap, not just water. Tip number 5, do not touch your beautiful face. Most people catch the virus with their mouth and nose. A majority of people don't get sick because of breathing the air, but because they touch something with their hand and then they touch their face. I will talk more about this in tip number 9. For now, do not touch your beautiful face. Tip number 6, do not go out. Take a break from all parties, old nightclubs, and restaurants. If you think that you can go to a small restaurant, sit in a corner table, and you'll be fine, you might be wrong. People who work in that restaurant provide service to a lot of people day after day. They give you a drink, you touch that glass, then you touch your face. This is how the virus gets spread. Symptoms of coronavirus may appear 14 days after exposure. Therefore, try to avoid all types of public places, social events, and meetings. And try to use public transportation as little as possible. Tip number 7, do not go to stores or malls. If you need to buy food, use a delivery service like Amazon Fresh or Ralph's Delivery. If your favorite store does not offer delivery, like Trader Joe's, which is my favorite store, then use a third-party delivery like Postmates or DoorDash. This video is not sponsored by anyone, I'm just giving you some options. If you really need to go to the store, then go in the morning or during the day, when there are less people. Do not go to the store on weekends. Do not taste anything in the store. I usually like to taste berries to make sure that they are sweet. Now I have to make a lucky guess. Before eating fruits and vegetables, wash them well. If a fruit has a peel, like an apple, peel it. Purchase more food and supplies than you usually do. Try to limit the amount of times you go shopping. That's simple. Tip number 8, use hand sanitizer. If you can't buy it, make it yourself. Use 2/3 cup of rubbing alcohol, specifically 91% of isopropyl alcohol, with 1/3 cup of aloe vera gel. Aloe vera gel, not juice. I made this mistake. I purchased juice. We need gel, not juice. For rubbing alcohol, you can use smaller percentage. The minimum concentration that CDC recommends is 60%. But if you really want it to be effective, try to find 91%. You can add a few drops of scented essential oil if you'd like. You can buy small travel containers like this one from Amazon. Again, do not go to the store, buy it online or use any small container that you have at home. I will post all links from Amazon for the items that I personally bought to make a hand sanitizer. Check them out in the description of this video. Tip number 9, wear a mask if you can buy one. There are 4 main reasons for wearing a mask. A. It prevents you from touching your beautiful face. You will notice that you want to touch your face, but the mask will stop you. You may be surprised, but the main danger is your hands. When you touch something, a food in the store, a door, a button in the elevator, even money, there is a chance that virus gets on your hands. The minute you touch your face, you're at risk. We touch our face to scratch our nose or our eye or to move our hair. We like to touch our face when we think. People touch their face way too often and don't even notice it. An average person touches his face more than 70 times a day. So one of the main reasons for wearing a mask is to prevent you touching your beautiful face. B. We need mask to scare people around you. When I go to buy food, I put my mask on. Magically, people in the store want to keep a distance from me. Now people try to avoid me and I can shop freely. C. The mask prevents us from breathing the air if somebody sneezes next to you. Don't forget, you have to squeeze the mask on top to prevent the air from coming from the top. Squeeze it here. And D, if you are infected, you can prevent the spread of the virus to those around you. But again, you should not be in a public place and should isolate yourself from others. Tip number 10. Take a shower and wear fresh, clean clothes every day. This sounds basic, but some people like to wear their favorite sweater or their favorite jeans for a week. This is the time for you to shine and show off your wardrobe. Tip number 11. If you have kids, make sure they do the same. You are responsible for your kids. If they don't listen, if they forget, this is your responsibility to remind them. You have to tell them 5, 10, 20 times if necessary until they remember. Limit their public events, extracurricular activities, and birthday parties. Of course, they will want to go and they might cry and complain, but this is your decision. You decide how much risk you're willing to take. Tip number 12, do not stress too much about the coronavirus. If you stress too much, your anxiety level will go up, your heart rate will go up, your blood pressure will rise, and all of a sudden you feel sick. You go to a hospital, there you have much bigger risk of catching a coronavirus or any other virus. Too much stress and anxiety might create even bigger problems. Also, according to my husband, who is a doctor, stress suppresses your immune system, which is the only defense you have against coronavirus. Tip number 13, do not stress too little about the coronavirus. If you don't take this seriously enough and don't think that there is a real risk, you could endanger your own health and others. You may think that other people are overreacting and exaggerating the situation. And I truly hope that you are right and they are wrong. But again, if there is a chance of getting sick and you don't take it seriously, then you will decrease your chance of being safe. If you don't follow simple prevention tips, then you are exposing yourself to potential sickness. The choice is yours. Be aware of the situation and do what you can to minimize the risk of getting sick. Tip number 14. Remember the main coronavirus symptoms: high temperature, cough, and shortness of breath. If you think that you are sick, first isolate yourself from your loved ones, take Tylenol and rest. However, if you feel that you are not feeling better after a day or two, call your doctor. If you have to go to the hospital, do not go to urgent care or small clinics like a Minute Clinic in CVS. At the time of recording this video, coronavirus tests are not available in those clinics. Also, if such clinics become associated with the case of at least one coronavirus patient, there is a big chance that they will send all their employees for 2-week quarantine and close their clinic. Of course, they don't want to close their business. If they have to do it, they will lose a lot of money. In 2 weeks after opening, they're still going to lose business because no one wants to go to a place that had a coronavirus case and was closed for quarantine. Would you go there? I would not. If I had to go, I would choose another hospital just to be safe. So they can't really diagnose the coronavirus and they are facing a risk of being quarantined. So there is a big chance that they either send you to another hospital or tell you to treat it as a regular flu. In case you have to go to the hospital and cannot contact your doctor by phone, go to a large hospital, not urgent care and not small private clinics. Tip number 14. Share this information with your friends and relatives, especially with your parents and grandparents. They are in a high risk group because of their age. Your parents might not be so handy in finding information about prevention tips. They might not trust the information that they read online, but if it comes from you, first, you show them that you care about them. And second, you can help them to lower their risk of getting sick. If you have additional tips, please share them in the comments section below. Let's exchange our knowledge and learn from each other. Let's fight this coronavirus together. If you find this video helpful, please click like and consider subscribing. Don't forget to share it on your social media with your friends and family. My name is Elena Semenek and this is Psychology of Happiness. Please ask your questions, share your comments below the video. See you soon. Bye. Of aloe vera juice. Марк, как сказать aloe vera по-английски? Aloe vera. Okay. Thank you. You can buy small traveler containers. Again. Wear fresh clean clothes. Okay. Cough. Shortness of breath. Quarantine. Would you? The minute you touch your face, you're at risk.
Что такое?
If you find this video helpful, please click like and consider subscribing. Don't forget to share it on your social media with your friends and family.